Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today is the day that we announce the giveaway winner. I was so cheap. I didn't want to go to the Dollar Tree to buy party favors. My coworker Lenore made these party favors. Look how cute. Very appropriate for our DIY channel. Thank you so much, Lenore. I also have a DIY for you. It's a bit of a trash to treasure, I would say. Sorry, I'm at work. I'll go low. Stay tuned to the end because I'm going to be announcing our winner. I know I'm being very, very annoying, but I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I think these are adorable. I don't know about you, but anyway, let's get on to the video. I had a few scraps of wood laying around. Why not take one of them and make a sign? I start off by taking my Varathane wood stain in the color Briarsmoke, which I absolutely love. And then, yes, I'm going to use the gloves to my Clairol root touch-up kit. I only have grays in the front of my head, you know, like Grandpa Munster. So I use the little brush that comes with the kit and save the gloves for messy projects like this. I use an old rag to apply the stain to my pine board, front, back, and all four sides. So in my last video, I used the insert from this pillow cover to create a fall pillow. If you didn't see that video, I will leave a link down below. Now I use this old pillow cover, but Dollar Tree has fleece baby blankets like this one right here. They also sell all different types of scarves and things like that, so you could also use those. Cut off the top part of the pillow cover. I only need one piece of material. Three coffee can lids. We drink a whole lot of coffee up in this piece. I save the lids and the tin cans as well. I use them to store my brushes or craft supplies. They come in really handy. So now I just trace around my lids onto the material. I turn the material upside down so you wouldn't see the pen mark. Now with these gigantic scissors that I got online, I cut around my circles. I make sure to leave about an inch or so of material so that I can glue it over my lid. I do this all the way around, little bits of hot glue, and then folding the material over. I make slits in certain areas so that the fabric won't bunch up on me and it'll make it a little bit easier to work with. I also use these tweezers that I got at the Dollar Tree. It just helps while you're pressing the material onto the lid and it prevents your girl over here from getting burnt like she always does. Now this is how it turns out, and I do this for all three of my lids. Take three pieces of the Dollar Tree nautical rope, which I have measured to fit all the way around each one of those lids. And I take my Apple Barrel antique white paint and just give this one coat. Taking a little bit of hot glue and working with small areas at a time, I glue the rope around all three lids. Once I get to the top, I just snip off the excess, whatever excess there is, and just glue that down. So can you believe I have some friends that are like, girl, you're always at Dollar Tree. You shop too much. They're so fresh. You never know when you're gonna need something. That's my motto. In my stash, I had a pack of peel and stick arrows. They come in a pack of three. Cover it with some Mod Podge so that the paint will adhere to it better, and then I take my Waverly chalk paint in the color Mineral and give it one coat. Originally, I was going to use Dollar Tree stickers to make this sign, but I decided against it. If you don't have a Cricut, they have wonderful stickers at the Dollar Tree that you could most certainly use to make this. I decided that I would make a stencil. The difference with the way that I make a stencil as opposed to when I make my signs with the Cricut and the lettering is that I weed opposite of what I normally would. taking out the letters instead of leaving them there. You can use any piece of scrap vinyl that you have laying around. It doesn't matter what color it is. And I also use the clear contact paper from the Dollar Tree to adhere my stencil to my project. It works really well for me, and it's only a dollar. Taking a small sponge brush and my antique white paint, I fill in my stencil. I start off with a thin layer and then I build from there. Then using my Cricut tool, I just take out the inside bits of the letters. DaFont.com is a great site to get fonts for free. All you have to do is download them to your computer and then upload them to your Cricut design space. I go ahead and glue my arrow onto my sign. I put some hot glue on all of the high points of the back of this lid, and then I glue it down to the piece of wood. Now with the second one, I'm going to do the same thing. However, when I place it, I'm going to go in about a quarter of an inch, I would say, maybe more. You guys know all about my math skills. What I'm trying to say is that I put it like on the corner of the first one. You kind of see what I'm doing here. And the last one, I just put glue on the top and the bottom. Those are the areas that are actually making contact. And I glue it right on top. Some hot glue on a tree stem, on a tree branch that I found outside. And I'm going to use this as my stem. I just glue it to the middle. So I consider you guys friends. Please don't judge me. I don't know how to make a bow. So this is what I do. This is my bow. I take some Dollar Tree ribbon and just crisscross it. I add a little tiny bit of glue. And then I take some raffia and I shape it into what I think looks like a bow. I've watched a gazillion YouTube videos and I still don't get it. I then take the raffia, which I also got at Dollar Tree, and just glue it on to the ribbon and take both and glue them onto my stem. Finally, I decided to add the words hot cocoa, hay rides, and corn maze at the bottom. I just felt that the sign needed something else down there. It was kind of empty. And then I used a small paintbrush and a little more paint, and I go over the letters just to make them look a little more handwritten. This is how my sign turned out. I absolutely love it. I think it's the perfect complement to the rest of my fall decor, which is very neutral. I have a very neutral palette in my home. I'm not a big fan of color, you know, like too many different colors. I love how budget-friendly this sign was, literally using lids from coffee cans that you would normally throw in the garbage, a piece of wood, just a few Dollar Tree products, and I have a gorgeous fall sign that I can use for years to come. I placed it on top of my mantel. If you're following me over at Instagram, you would have seen a short video that I put up of how I redid this mantle. I went ahead and bought some faux brick. My husband put it up for me behind the mantle, and I just painted it white with some chalk paint. I love the finished product. It looks fantastic. Wanted to show you how it looks at night with like some lights. I put my pumpkin up there that I made behind the window that I got at a flea market for $5, believe it or not. I put some of those string lights that I got. I picked them up, I think, at the Target Dollar Spot last year. I just love the way this looks at night. Super cozy. I'm ready for fall. This heat is driving me insane. I also wanted to take this opportunity to show you some of the things that I've done with items that I picked up and showed you in previous videos. I picked up this table at my local ReStore for $40.
It is a great piece of furniture. There was really nothing wrong with it. I went nuts this weekend. I did a lot. I decided to redo or revamp this table. All I did was paint the legs white, and then I stained the top of the table with the Varathane Briarsmoke stain that I used for the sign. I plan on painting the chairs white as well, but that'll be later on. I'm exhausted. Finally put up the clock that I bought at the Stormville flea market. This is usually sold at Kirkland's for, I think it's about $159, and I managed to score this for 20 bucks. So that's it for the video, guys. I really hope that you enjoyed this DIY fall sign and all of the updates that I've made to my home. I read every single one of your comments. I just wanted to let you know that sometimes it's a little difficult for me to answer every single one of you. The family is growing, but I want you to know that I appreciate you immensely. Thank you so much for your support. It may sound cliche, but you truly mean the world to me. All right, so the moment has arrived. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm on the actual video and I'm going to hit share. I will copy the link from the video and then I'm going to go to this YouTube random comment picker. It picks the winner for you. And I'm going to go ahead, right click, paste, and there is the video's URL right over here. And then the comment will include the word grateful. Let me type that in there because I asked you to tell me what you were grateful for. Are you guys ready? I'm so excited. Oh my God. I feel like I'm the one that's winning something. All right. So now I'm going to hit get YouTube comments. Oh my God, look at all these comments. Wow, 929 comments right over here. Okay guys, here we go. Start the raffle and pick the winner. You're going to be watching this part of the screen to see the name that comes up, okay? Here we go. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Lisa Copeland! Lisa, you won! Please send me all of your information so that I can send you your gifts. I am so, so happy for you. This is wonderful. And what did her comments say? I'm grateful for my life and everything that God has blessed me with. I'm really happy for you, Lisa. 929 people, and you won, Lisa. Congratulations. Thank you all so, so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.